friend Jonathan here to help me out. Come on, put your hands together for every
Yeah. Hello and welcome again to another broadcast from the Chaplaincy Department at the Norfolk and Norwich Hospital. Grace and peace to you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. It's great to be with you again, and as usual, I'm not on my own. I'm with my friend and my colleague, Reverend Rosemary, and I'm going to hand over to her to say hello to you, and she'll lead us through the next bit. So good morning, enjoy your time with us, and here's Rosemary.
Good morning, everyone. Yes, it's lovely to be with you again, and it's lovely to be able to praise the Lord. And that will be our theme this morning. Mark has chosen the theme of praise, and I'd like to open it up with three verses from Psalm 95. It's a song of praise. Come, let us praise the Lord. Let us sing for joy to God who protects us. Let us come before him with thanksgiving and sing joyful songs of praise. For the Lord is a mighty God, a mighty King over all gods. How wonderful is that? And we go into our first song, which is Praise the Lord.
Amen. Praise the Lord, and some more words of praise from the Bible. And this time we haven't gone to the book of Psalms or anywhere like that. We've gone to the book of 1 Chronicles, and as Rosemary and myself were just laughing at 1 Chronicles. So, it's a little passage here, words from King David. That was King David who wrote many of the Psalms of praise. But listen here to his words. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Proclaim the goodness of his salvation day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his wonders among all peoples. For the Lord is great and greatly to be praised. He is also to be feared above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols, but the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and gladness are in his place. Give to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Give to the Lord glory and strength. Give to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come before him. Oh, worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Tremble before him, all the earth. The world also is firmly established. It shall not be moved. Let the heavens rejoice and the earth be glad. Great words of praise and instruction for us all today. Let all the earth rejoice and let the heavens be glad. Rosemary, once I went to Israel and we went to the Wailing Wall just as the Sabbath was starting, and there was this sea of black as all the traditional Jews in their beautiful clothes went to the Wailing Wall to pray. And then about 2 hours later, there was this mass gathering of people in bright colours, and they'd come in from all the kibbutzes on the outsides around Jerusalem. And these were the Jewish settlers, and they gathered together and they linked arms and they danced towards the Western Wall to praise. It was a really moving sight. I'm moved now to see that. But they'd come to worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. Yeah. And David is saying that to us. Come on, everybody, find a way and a word to praise our God. So we're going to do that with our next song, which is How Great Is Our God.
The splendor of the King, clothed in majesty, let all the earth rejoice, all the earth rejoice. He wraps himself in light, darkness tries to hide, trembles at his voice, and trembles at his voice. How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? Oh, see how great. Time is great is our God.
And as we say, how great is our God, how wonderful he is, how great is his name. And we continue on with words of praise. This time we go right to the end, to Revelations. And when I read this book, it's just like reading a fantastical J.K. Rowling, yes. You know, the mystical creatures. And I can always remember my friend Rosemary, she was a Methodist, and she chose her service. She chose her service for her funeral. And she chose to have read all of Revelations 21. And we had to sit there and listen to her. And my friend turned around to me and said, she's having the last laugh. we really sat, that was the church on Ipswich Road, and that was absolutely packed with people. But the whole of Revelations 21, that was absolutely amazing, the way the person read it, you know. It is such a fantastic book. Anyway, I'm diverse. I'm reading from chapter 4, now at verses 9 till 11. The four living creatures sing songs of glory and honour and thanks to the one who sits on the throne, who lives forever and ever. When they do so, the 24 elders fall down before the one who sits on the throne and worship him who lives forever and ever. They throw their crowns down in front of the throne and say, our Lord and God, you are worthy to receive glory, honour and power, for you created all things, and by your will they were given existence and life. Wow. So everything we have goes down before the Lord. And that is reflected in our next song, Crown Him with Many Crowns.
Crown Him with many crowns, the Lamb upon His throne. Hark how the heavenly anthem drowns all music but its own. Awake my soul and sing of him who died for thee, and hail him as thy chosen king through all eternity. Crown him the Son of God. Lord, let your name be exalted on high.
Hearts and voices
gathered in unity, focus our eyes
on your glory.
Come in your spirit with power and might.
Let that power
flow through this nation and let there be light.
You are King of all kings. There is no one like you. Why should darkness remain where our God is proclaimed? Come in your power, the gates of this hell, at Jesus' name they will never prevail. Be exalted,
Lord, let your name be exalted on high.
Hearts and voices
gathered in unity, focus our in your spirit with power and might.
Let that power
flow through this nation and let there be light.
You are King of all kings. No one like you. Why should darkness remain where our God is proclaimed? Come in your power, the gates of this hell, at Jesus' name they will never prevail. Be exalted, Lord, let your name be exalted on high. Focus our eyes on your glory. Come in your spirit with power and might. Let that power flow through this nation and let there be light.
We pray together the prayer our Saviour taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory for ever and ever. Amen.
We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is, seen and unseen.
We believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made.
For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man.
For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
The Bible says my king is the king of the Jews. He's the king of Israel. He's the king of righteousness. He's the king of the ages. He's the king of heaven. He's the king of glory. He's the king of kings. And he's the Lord of lords. That's my king. I wonder, do you know him? My king is a sovereign king. No means of measure can define his limitless love. He's enduringly strong. He's entirely sincere. He's eternally steadfast. He's immortally graceful. He's imperially powerful. He's impartially merciful. Do you know him? He's the greatest phenomenon that has ever crossed the horizon of this world. He's God's son. He's a sinner's savior. He's the centerpiece of civilization. He's unparalleled. He's unprecedented. He is the loftiest idea in literature. He's the highest personality in philosophy. He's the fundamental doctrine of true theology. He's the only one qualified to be an all-sufficient savior. I wonder if you know him today. He supplies strength for the weak. He's available for the tempted and the tried. He sympathizes and he saves. He strengthens and sustains. He guards and he guides. He heals the sick. He cleanses the lepers. He forgives sinners. He discharges debtors. He delivers the captive. He defends the feeble. He blesses the young. He serves the unfortunate. He regards the aged. He rewards the diligent. And he beautifies the meek. I wonder if you know him. He's the key to knowledge. He's the wellspring of wisdom. He's the doorway of deliverance. He's the pathway of peace. He's the roadway of righteousness. He's the highway of holiness. He's the gateway of glory. Do you know him? Well, his life is matchless. His goodness is limitless. His mercy is everlasting. His love never changes. His word is enough. His grace is sufficient. His reign is righteous. And his yoke is easy. And his burden is light. I wish I could describe him to you. Yes, he's indescribable. He's incomprehensible. He's invincible. He's irresistible. You can't get him out of your mind. You can't get him off of your hand. You can't outlive him, and you can't live without him. Well, the Pharisees couldn't stand him, but they found out they couldn't stop him. Pilate couldn't find any fault in him. Herod couldn't kill him. Death couldn't handle him, and the grave couldn't hold him. Yeah! That's my king. That's my king. Amen.
I worship you.
Well, there we are. We're at the end of our program. Again, it's always a delight to be with you. We enjoy it, and we've had a little bit more music today and a little bit less talking from Rosemary and myself. But we hope that that's allowed you to find a theme of praise in your own heart to worship the Lord our God. I think in every situation in life, we do well if there is a way that we can find to praise him. Rosemary, have you ever watched the film Pollyanna?
Yes, I have.
And
yeah.
This little girl, Pollyanna, arrives in this small community of people, and she's quite a little firebrand amongst them, because she's got this, well, many people find it annoying, this annoying habit of looking at every circumstance she comes across and finding a way to rejoice in it. Her father was a missionary, apparently, and told her how many rejoicing texts there are in the Bible. And she wins the heart of a community. And I think we can win the heart of God if in everything, even in our darkest moment, we can find a way to praise God. And we may not feel like it, and we may be full of anger or guilt or whatever. But if we can just say something like, I praise you.
Yeah.
Because you've given me life again today, or I thank you because you'd never abandon me, then the theme of praise is always on our lips. And this is the last Bible verse that we want to leave you with today. It's from Psalm 34, and it's verse 1. And again, it's King David. He writes this: I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. That's a spiritual challenge for us all this week. I wonder if you'll accept it or not. We're going to say goodbye to you now. So we'll let Rosemary say goodbye first this morning.
Yes, I'd like to say goodbye with a few words. So as we leave today, we give praise to our Maker with our whole hearts, and we declare the might of the Lord, and we give praise to Christ with our whole hearts, and we declare the love of the Lord, and we give praise to the Spirit with our whole hearts, and we declare the wisdom of the Lord, and we praise the Lord, and may we go out and be Pollyannas today.
Yes. Well, go in peace to love and serve the Lord, and I pray that as you go, you might know the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit upon you, remaining with you now and always. Amen.
Amen.
Our last song is called the UK Blessing. You'll hear many different voices as they sing the blessing that's recorded in the Book of Numbers. And whilst the church has been unable to gather, voices from many churches all over the United Kingdom have come together over the internet, and they've put together this beautiful song of blessing. I hope it blesses you, and I hope it moves you as well. But until next time, it's goodbye from me.
And goodbye from me.
Take care.
Amen. Amen. From heaven, this isn't second guessing. We know that we are protected. May the peace that surpasses all understanding be our message. Grace and favors in your nature, in your essence.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations,
and your family, and your children,
and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you, and a thousand generations, and your family, and your children, and their children, and their children. May his favor be upon you, and a thousand generations, and your family. In the children, may his presence go before you and behind you and beside you.